Hello, I'm Mr. Anitjar, editor, lecturer in metallurgy. And recently, you know, this YouTube had objected to my video, which was very simple and straightforward. The reason is this, you know, that most people that you come across, they have no idea of the gospel. They read the dead letters of the holy books, Bible, Quran, Ad-Granth, and everything. But they don't think logically. If you think logically, then the gospel gets written over your heart. Then you can see the corruptions and everything that had taken place. But most people, they love darkness. So they want to carry on cheating people and doing wrong things and suffer. When they suffer, as in Iraq, you know, the people or these Mohammedans start cutting the throat of the so-called Christian. Then everybody will say, what's happening is wrong. But if I tell you why it is happening wrong and what you should do, then you object to it and ban my videos. That is not right. I have no grudge against anyone. In Jesus or in God, we love each everyone because everyone has to give his own account to God. I can't give their account to God. So these middlemen, these dog collar priests and other things, they are antichrist. And most people go after them. So they are super blind. So what can I do? So here is a, I have written something that will throw some more light. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. delivered by the first anointed Christ, which in my native language Punjabi we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. Remember that Jesus said, I will make you the sons of the Most High, and that is the living God, which is Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. And I am the living son of that living God, not of any dead one. So that dwells within his temple of God. This is the temple of God, created by the demiurge potter, the lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda. So this is created by Yahweh. Yahweh is the, all the nature that you see with the two naked eyes belong to Yahweh. The life inside it that make the things living is of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. So most people don't know that there are two gods, demiurge and real. And in the universities, they have no idea at all. They are super blind. So train from them what they can think about me and other, you can well imagine. Khuda, etc., the greatest artist of all, he had left no imperfection in this one. Then why you have circumcision? Tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Only the people of Isaac can have circumcision, nobody else. If he does have the circumcision, then he becomes the sons of Isaac. If he is a Negro, Isaac wasn't a Negro, he was a Semitic race. If you are a white man, Aryan, then Abraham was not a Aryan, or Isaac wasn't Aryan. He was Semitic race. Then you become, you can't build your covenant with Isaac. So the circumcision is to build your covenant with Isaac. But people are, you know, the temple priests, they wanted to circumcise the people to make them Jew outwardly of appearance and take money out of them. So that is the, now the downfall. Nobody, hardly anybody knows in whose name John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water, and why he did not baptize a woman, a Gentile or a Samaritan. I know it, but they can't know it unless God giveth them the power to know it. So by the grace you get all these things, so you can't blame them when they object to my object videos. But the YouTube should be sensible not to delete my videos or anything like that. So Khuda, etc., the greatest artist of all, and it is called Harmandir. Harmandir means temple of God, not made by human hands, but by the Lord of the nature, Yahweh. That is why Jesus said, I am the Lord of Sabbath, because the soul inside is greater than this one. So our living father is greater than this demiurge. Called Harmandir Immanuel, God is with us if you are not cheating people, if your heart is clean. Remember Peter as the gatekeeper, feeding the sheep into the kingdom of heaven, into the royal kingdom of God. So he killed Ananias and Sapphira, for both of them had spoken lies. And Peter asked them twice, you know, is that all you got out of the sale? And they said yes. They told lies from the very core of their heart, which is called blasphemy. So Peter killed them both. So remember that to enter the fold of God is not cheap. And not many people are interested in it. They sing the songs and everything, but they fear to go into it. Church of England, headed by Queen, or King now, rich in mammon, how can he enter into the fold of God, where you don't take any money, no two shoe, no tunic, no script. Script is not allowed. So all these nonsense, you see, that create objections to my videos, which exposes them. That is the purpose of the gospel, to expose the hypocrites. So don't worry, God, you can't speak gospel without the grace of our supernatural Father, or unless you become the Son of the Most High. I am the Son of the Most High. I am not a Christian. I am a Christ. Remember St. Thomas went to India, South India? Over there he was known as Christ Thomas, and so were his laborers Christ, because they could preach gospel from the core of their hearts. They don't need to open Bible or anything. Bible is forbidden in the royal kingdom of God. No money, no two shoe, no tunic, no script, no scripture. That is the Jewish leaven, which is forbidden by Christ Jesus. And now you have the Jewish leaven Bible in the churches. So what you expect? Then they are antichrist. And when I tell them, expose the hypocrisy, then they object to my videos. Hi, brethren. We are very, very fortunate to have the chosen people of priest among us, the so-called in the middle of the Jews, you know, they have the temple and all that thing, you know. They are the chosen people, which are of Abraham. You remember that Abraham used to be called Abram. He was picked up from the Iraq area, where there was a good seed, good rootstock. Remember, if somebody want to plant a garden or a orchard, then he will always look for a good rootstock, so that the crop will be good. So that's why Abram was picked up from the Iraq area, a good rootstock. and he was planted by Yahweh in the Middle East as Adam, Sarah as Eve, and he was given the promised land as the Garden of Eden. So whenever the people were faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh, this land was lush green of honey and milk. As soon as they become unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, the same land became barren. Remember, Jacob had 12 sons. Only one was faithful to Abraham or to Jacob. He was Joseph. The other 11 crook brothers, they wanted to kill him because he would tell the truth to the father. So instead of killing him, they sold him as a slave to the Egyptian. So as soon as he left the promised land, then the Abraham was not happy, because Abraham is the father of the faithful, not of the crooks. And Yahweh, who planted them there, he was much more angry. He is jealous and revengeful. So when they became unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, and unfaithful to Jacob, then he gave them no rain, and the land became totally barren. They have to leave the land for Egypt, and in Egypt they suffered. That the story of the prodigal son. The prodigal son is Isaac, the elder son is Ishmael, people Egyptian, who were eating meager, not as lavish as the chosen people. And Moses then brought them back, faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh, and the same land became lush green. So Yahweh welcomed them back into the house. Today you see these hurricanes and other things happening in the world. It has nothing to do with the climate and all that changes. They are theories they are putting up. It is because they are unfaithful to Yahweh, and they are unfaithful to their tribal fathers. They have forgotten their tribal fathers. And they are not the salt of the earth people. They are after money, how to cheat people and how to become rich. And that is why the mammon is of Satan. And that is why, you know, these countries of Satan, where the money is misused, they are suffering. Here is a cartoon made by a Green Party deputy head, where she shows the people who are unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, that is rich in mammon. This is a Jewish man. This sickle has Jewish David's cross. Jewish man of America, American flag. He is causing all these bloodsheds in the different countries. So what should happen to America if the Jewish man is saltless person? There should be hurricanes, there should be floods, and there should be destruction by Yahweh. Yahweh is bringing hurricanes and floods and everything in America and other countries, wherever people are cheating. People in a Brazilian jungle and African jungle, they have tribal mark on their faces, and they live peacefully among themselves as brethren. And over there, you don't get hurricanes or anything like that, or strong wind or anything. Their houses are of straw, of straw which can easily blow up. But as they are faithful to Yahweh, Brahma Khuda, no harm comes to them. if you become faithful to the our supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, then how much you would be protected. I tell you, on 17th April this year, I went to London to Hyde Park Corner to preach gospel. I took all my banners with me, there were about 22 of them, heavy load, and not many people were interested, only one or two, you know, looking at the banners with curiosity. So I thought, oh, it's not worth it coming here. I packed up and coming back, there's a Hyde Park Corner where I have to catch the bus to Reading. And there's a roundabout, the bus stopped at the other end of the roundabout, so I have to cross the road. I have to go down the roundabout, then up again. As I was climbing up, you know, both of my hands were occupied, and I fell forward, backward, and my head hit the railing very badly. And blood came out of my head, and I caught the bus. Somebody helped me to take my bag to the bus stop, and I have caught the bus. I was testing my neck if I had something broken, no pain, just in the back, you know, there was strain. So then I went, reached home, carrying all those bags and everything, which was about 20 kilo each, you know, on both hands, and went to hospital to get a dressed up. And over there they found I have broken 3 bones in the back, and one is has a bigger space. So much damage. And they were surprised, you know, that I came all the way carrying good things with all that damage, you know. And then after a couple of days, the doctor came to test if I have anything wrong. They tested my hands, no sensation, nothing wrong. And they said, okay, we'll give you a collar to put it on. So I put the collar on for it was 7 weeks, I think, and put the collar on, and collar taken after on 14 June. So I went to gym and other thing, started my exercises, and I'm improving every day. No major damage. I can lift weight and everything back as I used to be, but only jogging is a little bit problem, so it will be all right. 95% I'm back to normal. So God looked after me. I could have been paralyzed, I could have been dead, you know, with that things. So if you work for God, God looks after you. So I'm very happy and thankful to God. So doing thanking him by producing more videos and YouTube videos and other things, you know. So let's carry on with our what I've written. We are very fortunate to have the chosen people of priest among us, and through them we learn how to live in this world, secular world, how we live peacefully. I hail from Punjab, India, where the second coming of Jesus took place in 1469 in the name of Christ or Satguru Nanak Dev Ji. Now, Satguru and Christ is the same thing, Punjabi and English. Most of the people address Nanak as a Guru Nanak. Guru means a moral teacher. But Nanak wasn't a moral teacher, he was a spiritual preacher, he was a Christ. So you can see how many people know that Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. So if they don't know, one in a million knows. And then you can see what people will call me. When I preach gospel, they will call me that I am a heretic, as people call Jesus a heretic in Jerusalem. Sadhguru Nanak Dev is among the most spiritually sick people. So the doctor, they are the spiritual doctor, you know, Christ Jesus and Christ Nanak. They come among the most spiritually sick people of the Khatri tribe. Nanak came among the Khatri tribe, and Jesus came among the people of Judah tribe, which were greedy. And you remember at the time of David, people of Judah tribe were very good. They were very performing, you know, things and everything, honest and everything. In this dark age, they become opposite. Instead of honest, they are the most dishonest people you can come across. Same as people of Khatri tribe. They were very good at the time of Lord Krishna. Ramchandra. Shri Ramchandra. They were very good at that time. Honest, and that's why the Kshatri Varna profession is dedicated to people of Khatri tribe. But in this dark age, they become number one crook in the world of Khatri tribe. The people of the Judah tribe, among whom Christ Jesus, the first anointed royal high priest, came, are just princes of darkness. So remember, Jesus said princes of darkness, and where there's a prince, there's a king and emperors also. Princes of darkness, whilst the people of the Khatri tribe, where I come from, Punjab, India, are kings and emperors of darkness, hating the light most. So the people who are of darkness, they hate the light. So I'm not worried that they are banning my videos and taking it off the YouTube. Thus, what I tell in my YouTube video is the gospel truth that exposes the hypocrite, that you get through logical reasoning yourself, and not by reading the holy books alone. Such people are rare to come across. One in 1,000, two in 10,000, and among the so-called sects, one in 1,000,000. So gospel is not that cheap. So I'm not wondering that they have taken my videos off the YouTube. So God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love. So in God, we love and serve people and not hate them. Hatred is of Satan. Love is of God. Our Father God blesses everyone. You know, you can see how much the Church of England loves people, that the soldiers who died in World War I, World War II, they proclaim that they glorify God. Is that the way the God is glorified? Whereas the Salvation Army people say they died for king and country, which is the gospel truth. Our Father God, bless you.